بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And let us start our talk with a dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help us and can help all communities and every corner of the globe to put an end to this issue and to eradicate everything relates to the coronavirus. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the best of blessings, the best of health, and the best in everything that He provided us with or that He granted us. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. In a few words, I would like to just shed more light on the issue of coronavirus from a religious viewpoint. I'm not a physician, I'm not a doctor to talk about, because that's not my field actually, but my field is how to talk about this issue from a religious viewpoint. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran in more than one place, He talks about the issue of ibtila, test. وَنَبْلُوَكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He confirms in the Quran that He's gonna test us with sometimes goodness or sometimes something that we might not like. Like, for example, some type of disease, some viruses, some illness, something that we as a human being sometimes we might suffer, because that is what He already planned before. That's what we know as the issue of qadar or predestination, or some people translate it as fate. The qadar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the last part or the last pillar of faith. Faith has six pillars, the last of which is أن تؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره حلوه ومره. To believe in the qadr, whether it is something you like or something you dislike. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planned. Nothing in this universe can happen without the permission, without the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah azza wa jal, He is the one who already decided that. And He said in the Quran, in more than one place, in the chapter of Al-Baqarah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, we're gonna test you in different ways. And at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, and give good news to those who are patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the question that we might need to ask ourselves, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing people? Why? The verse makes it very, very clear, وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ, to us you are gonna return. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, return or turn, both have the same significance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as He said in another place, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, in order to test which of you is going to do best and which of you is going to have patience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not necessarily that you need to understand the qadr. The qadr is something very vague, something that sometimes we are unable to understand. And I'll give you an example, the issue or the story of Al-Khadr alayhi salam and Musa alayhi salam, as mentioned in the last part of Surah Al-Kahf. Al-Khadr, suddenly he decided, he got a boat with Musa alayhi salam, with Moses, and suddenly he decided to make a hole in that boat, to make it defective. So the people of the boat, maybe till they passed away, they do not understand why this man has done this to their boat. What's the issue? What the significance? Here, that's the qadr. Al-Khadr alayhi salam, he was just executing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, as He explained in the last part of the verse, وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي, I did not do that out of my own, but this is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe when he killed that little boy, the family of this boy, maybe till the last minute of their life, they were unable to understand why their boy was killed, for example. That is the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We might be unable to understand, or our mentality is unable to comprehend everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already planned. So my reaction when everything is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have to accept it with all kind of satisfaction, with all kind of pleasure, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He provided already, or he promised a place for those who are pleased with the qadar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, if you look at the media, maybe we can move a little bit away from the issue of the qadar or the predestination. A lot of people are sharing some news and making people scared. That's not the issue. We need to cooperate one with another, to help with one another, to support one another. So at the end, inshallah, we can cross this bridge. At the end, inshallah, we can help each other to come and end with a beautiful end. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already eradicated the issue of coronavirus, but this is by our support. So what we need to do, we should never feel panic or feel scared. Sometimes I felt through the media, through some websites, the Facebook, people are a little bit so scared. Again, go back to the beginning of my talk. It's about the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that's the faith that we need to understand, that the faith that we need to have. He is teaching Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with them, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُخْضِئَكَ وَمَا أَخْضَأَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُصِيبَكَ. And you have to know that whatever was going to happen to you, it will happen. Nobody can stop it. No power on earth can stop it. And whatever was going to miss you will never happen to you. If something was going to miss you by will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will never happen to you. In Surah At-Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the very beautiful verse, and all verses of the Quran are beautiful, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. Very clear, very decisive, very sharp. Nothing will happen. Nothing will inflict us except but what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already decided before. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ هُوَ مَوْلَانَا. Who is the one who's going to support us? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is the one who's going to remove that calamity? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is the one who's going to make way out? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, after using the methods we have, like for example, taking the consultation of medical resources, physicians, scientists, and all these things. But at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. It's on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believers, they rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your role now, your task now, just feel relaxed. Take it easy, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never let us down at all. Keep making dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us more than one dua that we can say in the morning, that we can say in the evening. But again, take your all precautions, like washing the hands. Don't go into like big crowds and all these things that we hear from those who are specialists. But my role as Imam, I would ask everybody to go back to the Quran, to go back to the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At the time of calamity, at the time of difficulty like what we are going through now, we need consolidation, we need support, we need to cooperate with one another, inshallah. If there is a decision about, for example, suspending Friday prayer for some time, that's fine, inshallah. For sure, we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us to get rid of this issue very soon. And inshallah, we're going to have back our Friday prayer, the rest of activities. And we need to have a good thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ana and dhan abdi bi. I am at the good thinking of my worshipper. If you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us to overcome this issue, for sure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us, inshallah, to overcome this issue. Although, I'm sure that this issue, many people will be affected. Business owners, local businesses, maybe restaurants. Many people, they're going to be affected. For sure, there's no doubt about that. Again, remember the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ. You're going to lose some money. That is a test by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we take the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the pleasure, and we say Alhamdulillah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us in the hadith, and we know from his seerah that he used to say Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal, Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all circumstances and in all occasions. Whatever comes of Allah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is great, whether something I like, maybe something I don't like now, but in the future I will find out that subhanAllah, the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always the best. Again, my respected brothers and sisters, we need again to just support one another, inshallah, cooperate, help, and never listen to rumors, scams, and always try to give good news to people. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I would love to end with this very beautiful hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam: "Yassiru wa la ta'assiru." Make things easy to people. Don't make things difficult to people. "Wabashshiru wa la tunaffiru." Give good news, bishara, glad tidings to people, and don't tell them about bad news. Some people, they have the habit of, okay, today a number of people died, a number of people were inflicted. Forget about this issue. Always give hope, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He taught us. Remember, I made a khutbah before about the issue of hope. We need to give hope to people. We need to give good news to people. We need to make people love life, because this life is very beautiful. It's a gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us enjoy His blessings, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa to everybody and protect our community, all other communities, all the United States, every corner of the globe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all people against all types of viruses, sorry, or illnesses. And inshallah, tomorrow will continue and we will know some good aspects of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more specifically the issue of coronavirus. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us against it. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khayran wa barakallahu feekum wa ahsanallahu alaykum wa assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.